Oh, Boys.
Yeah!
Thank you. So first up, mate, obviously not the result you're hoping for. Is there any concerns?
No, not really. Not really. There was a lot of positives to come out of that. Look, I think we addressed it after the game that we probably made some poor decisions during the game. But look, on the whole, there's a lot of positives to work from. I'm happy that we fought back in the end. I'm happy that we scored some points when we were down. But we've just got to work on a couple of processes and... I'm looking forward to the next game.
It was a pretty tight game towards the end. It felt like you guys might have left the run a bit too late.
Yeah, possibly. Again, we made some poor decisions and that affected our run into the end of the game. But on the whole, it wasn't too bad.
Based on trial form and training this off-season, were you expecting a performance like that from your guys?
We've only had one trial, so we've only actually played... the team's only played one half of football, to be honest. And we started the pre-season a bit late, but anyway, look, no excuses. We were beaten by a very good Noosa team. They were hungry, and they played really, really well.
They've got quite a young side. Is it hard to get the mix right between the experience and the younger players?
No, not really. It's just ability. So if you're good enough, you're old enough, regardless. We had a 17-year-old out there today, and we had a Jason Wilborn's 38. So, you know, it's... if you're good enough, you're old enough. It doesn't matter what age you are.
You're reasonably happy with the 15 that you got on the park today?
He only lasted 18 minutes.
Yeah. Did the loss of guys like Jackson Foley, Reece Clayton and Simon Lang hurt your back line?
No, not really. I've got a lot of faith in the guys who were there, Matty Leader and Brett in the centres and the wingers. Look, no, I'm happy with who we've got. I'm happy with how they're going to go and looking forward to see how they go in the next few weeks.
And who have you guys got next week?
We've got Calandra next week and Boyle after that.
Okay, and I guess it's hard to know what to expect off Calandra too.
They're going to be big. They're going to be very direct and they're going to be very fit. They've had the week off. They're going to be very fit. They've had a good pre-season. They're heading the right direction, Calandra. I've always said that Calandra are probably the dark horse this year. A lot of good things happening down at Calandra. They'll be tough and I'd expect next week game to be as tough as today.
All right, mate, first up, there's a pretty big game out there, pretty physical game. You're pretty happy with the outcome?
Yeah, it's round one and it's a good result for us. And bottom line, both teams will get better.
Yeah, were the parts of the game that disappointed you from your team? Or?
I felt for a first up game, it went better than we expected. We hadn't had a lot of continuity, so up until then we knew we were playing the premiers, so it's a big ask. But yeah, we just were worried about our own backyard and we just wanted to do what we needed to do.
Yeah, it seemed like Uni were on the charge in the last sort of 20 minutes and you've done well to hold them off.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you get momentum shifts in games and Uni won the last 20. But in saying that, I thought, you know, we transitioned really well between attack and defence and scored some great tries from out wide.
So it's a pretty new-looking side compared to last year. Were you reasonably happy with the new outfit?
Yeah, more than happy for a first-up effort. It's great. We have traditionally had a big turnaround anyway. So I think last year when we played our first-round game, we only had five starting from the previous year's grand final. It's the same today.
So the way that you were working on them during the week, were you happy with the way they played, like the way that you wanted them to play? Or?
I'm a coach, so I'm never fully happy. We got lots to work on, but it was very encouraging.
And you're pretty settled on the 15 you've got now?
The good thing is we've got competition, we've got other guys coming back next week, and so it makes for a great foundation for the rest of the season.
And last question here, mate. How did off-season signing go, Tom Mathberry go?
The million-dollar man. Tommy's been great for us, and he's a very humble man, and he's got a real presence on the field, and the boys like to follow him. They're very young and impressionable, so he's a good balance for them.